Well, at the foundation where we work on infectious disease, there'll be meetings where people say, oh, the gut bacteria affect this, or there's a bacteria in this insect. And Sue, who's the CEO of the foundation, found this book and came in and handed me a copy and said, oh, this really shows the landscape of this amazing phenomena of how microbes are such a key part of all life forms.
That's right. So I went to this germ-free facility where they raise mice in these sterile bubbles. Those mice do not contain multitudes. They've never seen bacteria in their lives. And because of that, their bodies, unexpected things like their bones and their blood vessels don't develop in the right way if they don't encounter the right microbial signals.
One thing we work on, you describe, is this idea that Wolbachia lives inside insects, and the case of the Aedes aegypti mosquito can actually reduce its ability to be disease carrying.
The idea that we might be able to control all these diseases by implanting Wolbachia into the Aedes aegypti mosquito just blows my mind. And Wolbachia, when it was first discovered, was ignored. It took a lot of time before people realized that it had the potential to influence human health in such a positive way. The microbiome is very much like that, long ignored and now only recently appreciated.
Yeah, I think the last place I would have expected any microbiome connection is a neurological disease like Parkinson's.
Yeah, and there's so many interesting links between the microbiome in the gut and brain and behavior. I think the microbiome provides this connective tissue that links all of our organ systems together, and it influences the way we think, the way we behave. But the idea of organisms that are microscopic changing the way we think feels kind of deeply unsettling, and yet there it is.
Yeah, the fact that it stays under control, I find it amazing how complex the microbiome is, and would not have expected this.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's the kind of grander view of life that I wanted to get across in the book, that you and I are sitting here as two individuals, but actually we're two entire worlds.
Hey, thanks, Ed. It's great to have you here.
Thank you for having me. It's been fantastic.